Last week, Canada announced it has legalized the use and selling of cannabis for recreational use and instantaneously created a multi-billion dollar industry. But most people don't realize that the body creates its own happy chemicals that you can use to help you achieve your goals. Cue intro. Hi everybody, it's Dr. Sam Adichie with another video for NobodyMotivation.com, where we aim to hit you up with videos on a weekly basis designed to educate, motivate and inspire you to achieve your biggest, brightest, boldest goals. Now, the journey to achieving your goals can be a very lonely journey indeed. Many people have reported low mood, depression, anxiety. All these things are triggered by the fact that you're going against the grain. You're doing something that maybe has not been done before. Truly, entrepreneurs grapple with these thoughts of not being able to meet up to their full potential because of these negative thoughts that keep weighing them down. And without support from their peers, family members, or friends, they will struggle. Okay? And in fact, this has been evidenced by a study by Dr. Freeman in 2015 for entrepreneurs that revealed that 49% have disclosed mental health problems within the first couple of years of starting their business. And an organization set up in 2016 to help budding musicians kickstart their career found out that 73% of them were reporting also depression and anxiety. So these chemicals are so important. But as I said in the intro, the body produces some of these chemicals by itself to help you. So this makes understanding the four chemical companions that we all have in our brains and understanding how to activate them even more important. In fact, the brain itself has evolved from hundreds of thousands, if not millions of years of evolution, whereby if you go back to the ancient cave dweller whose primary focus was to propel his gene line and also to survive things such as saber-toothed tigers, woolly mammoths, all those types of things, okay? These chemicals that the body was producing, which I refer to as companions because they're there for you. We all produce these chemicals, okay? And I'll talk you through in this video how to activate them and how to get the best out of them. The whole concept of survival has changed drastically. We're not running away from wild animals, okay? We're in our comforts of our home, particularly those of us that live in the developed world, we've got all our creature comforts. So, the body has a very quirky way of defining what it needs for its survival. So, in order for us to take a look at these chemicals in actions, sometimes it's very difficult for us to see them at play within ourselves, because we're too busy in the moment living their experience. So sometimes it's easier to see it in other people. So what I've done in this video, I'm going to use four key people that I've identified with in order to talk you through the chemicals in action. The first one being endorphins. Now back in the day, this would help you when you were injured, get help. Okay, this gives you a sense of euphoria. This is released in the body when you overcome a lot of stress. Maybe you've done a very hard gym workout or you've gone for a very long distance run. That releases endorphins. Okay, it's a feeling that you get of euphoria when your body has gone through a lot of stress, a lot of trauma. Okay, now the problem with doing that and I'm being, say, addicted to the feeling of endorphins, is you always have to push your body, if you're going to the gym, past its limits. And this leads to a lot of people having muscle fatigue and burnout. Have you ever gone to the gym and really gone flat out and felt great moments straight after the gym, but never went to the gym again after that? It's because psychologically, you know you push yourself too far, and to release that level of endorphins, you need to go past that level again, and that means even more stress that you're going to put on yourself. So for people who go to the gym, particularly amateurs, they need to really pay attention to how the body is releasing endorphins. And what you can do is vary up the exercises in order for you to still get that sense and that rush of achieving something if your endorphins fine, because you're exercising different parts of your body. Now, you could do that by exercise variation, you could do that by different intervals of exercising. So instead of going in the morning, you could go in the afternoon, use a partner, just change it all up. Variety is what you need. So endorphins help you to mask pain, okay? Now, I identify that with Deadpool, minus the jokes, but it's important to recognize what is happening there. He's not feeling those pains because his endorphins are off the scale. Now, the second one being dopamine. Now, our ancestors felt joy every time they were hunting and gathering and actually accomplished their goal. It could have been a cave person finding a berry, or it could be you taking down a wild beast, okay? That whole sense of accomplishment, okay, triggers the chemical dopamine. So dopamine is a facilitator chemical for you to keep on making strides to achieve your goals. Dopamine is released, okay? So a good example of that is, say, Dejan Lovren. I'm a Liverpool fan, so I have to use this example. In the 4-3 win against Borussia Dortmund, he comes in with a flying header and scores in literally the last minute, okay? Now, why is this important? If you watch that clip, you see Dejan Lovren going up for a header and scoring. That is dopamine. He has achieved his goal. And the euphoria erupts across the stadium for Liverpool fans, heartache for Borussia Dortmund fans. But the concept I'm trying to get you to grasp is dopamine was released. It was released in such abundance that Dejan Lovren actually done a two-footed scissors kick celebration that he's never done since. If the score had been, say, 10-0 to Liverpool, and he has scored, he would have had dopamine, but it had been far less in measurement, okay? And because the dopamine would have been reduced, his celebration would have been so ecstatic. Dopamine, we really have to take a very, very close look at it, particularly in the pursuit of our own goals. The best way I say to get dopamine is on a daily basis, by every night making daily strides to achieve your goals by identifying one key task. I said this before in my other videos, using the 140 rule, break down that task into no more than 140 characters before you go to bed. Think about it through. Then the next day, you will probably achieve that goal because it's more structured. It's no longer wishy-washy, and then you get your fix of dopamine, will allow you to continue making those strides. If you try to be too complicated, okay, you will not hit your mark. So always make daily strides to achieve your goals using the 140 rule. You get your daily dose of dopamine. Now, dopamine is so crucial. I'm gonna give you another example because my channel is all about helping you to achieve your goals, okay? Now, I'm an old school gamer. So I used to spend all day long playing video games, right? Now, the video game industry is worth billions, we know that. But if you take a closer look at somebody playing a video game, you will know when dopamine is released. Dopamine is released when you know on each level you are overcoming certain obstacles, okay? And that is why when you do a certain sequence and you beat the final boss, say you're playing Manic Miner, you dodge all the obstacles and you go to the next level, dopamine is released. Next level, you do the same thing, dopamine is released. So much dopamine is released in the confines of people's bedrooms. It is clear that the video games industry needs to take a closer look at what is happening to these young people who are engaged in playing video games. Because dopamine, as a chemical, is very, very addictive indeed. So what else can boost your dopamine levels? You can listen to music. And have you ever noticed that when you're listening to a song and you kind of like get the beat, you kind of understand what the next lyric's going to be? Dopamine is what's going to be released. that allows you to feel a sense of accomplishment. You've achieved something. This is why when we listen to radio stations playing familiar music, we like it. But I've also taken a look at the fact that when you play in your own playlist, you sort of get numb to the songs. As the body becomes familiar with the song, the lyrics, the music, less and less dopamine is released until we get something that is new but sounds familiar to us. Then we start getting that dopamine released again through our bodies. Other things we could do to release dopamine is to exercise regularly. Not too excessively, but exercise regularly. You get your dose of dopamine. You can relax, go through meditation, have a body massage. These types of things also stimulate dopamine in our bodies. And as long as we're making daily strides to achieve our goals, you will get that dopamine rush. Okay, enough to keep you moving forward and doing the same thing. Repetition loves dopamine. When you can repeat things that is moving you forward to achieving your purpose, you get enough dopamine. You will not need to reach out for the drug that is synonymous to being aligned to excessive amounts of dopamine, and that is cocaine. You don't need to go that route. Number three is serotonin, otherwise known as the happy chemical, because it helps your brain regulate your mood, okay? Serotonin is that chemical that's released, particularly in social groups, when you now are recognized for something that you've done. You are now recognized for an achievement by your own peers. It could have been you who posted that comment on Facebook that got 100, 200, 1,000 likes, okay? It could have been you who got promoted in front of all your peers. That will give you that rush of serotonin. When you don't have serotonin or enough levels of serotonin to regulate your body correctly, normally you end up having, along with talking therapies, if you go in the medicinal route, you might be prescribed antidepressants, because these antidepressants target your serotonin levels, helps to activate them and boost your mood up, okay? So serotonin is that one about status, like in The Great Gatsby, okay? It's all about status, being recognized. If we were to go back to the cave dwelling days, we would have to be recognized within our own pack, within our own group, in order to survive. Because if you're not recognized for the things you do, you risk being isolated from the pack, isolated from the herd. And you know what happens when you break free from the herd and a wild animal approaches. It will target you. So being recognized within the pack, within the herd, is also something that is very, very important. But recognize this one other lesson. The herd moves when the herd moves. This is why it's important to stay connected to whatever social group that you're in, but also be able to take a step back, take a look across the horizon, scan the Serengeti, scan your options, okay? Don't be so entrenched in anything, because true leaders are there because they see what others cannot see, and they have the fortitude to act on things they know. And so if you want to know things, you have to experience other things. Serotonin, to close, is all about regulation of your mood, status. It is the happy chemical. Now, how do you then stimulate serotonin? You can stimulate serotonin by being exposed to sunlight, vitamin D. Put your sun cream on, but yes, exposure to enough sunlight boosts your serotonin levels. So countries that don't have a lot of sunlight have a high prevalence of depression amongst the population. So give yourself vitamin D once in a while to help boost your serotonin levels. So what else can you do to boost your serotonin levels? Well, you can exercise more regularly. You can start to think more positive thoughts. You can engage in language that's actually going to liberate you, that's going to enable you, that's going to inspire you, that's going to make you think that you are better, okay, opposed to thinking and using language that belittles you. There's one word I don't like using often, and that is just. When you hear somebody use the expression, I'm just doing this, I'm just doing that, it's a very defeatist word, okay? It makes them feel low. You're not just anything. Remove the word just and just say what you are doing. You're not just existing. You exist. Okay? So remove words like that, that take away your power. Use words that empower you. In fact, I'm going to do a video on words that empower you next. Last but not least is number four, which is oxytocin. This is the chemical of love. This is a chemical that's released in your body when you feel connected, first and foremost, with your family. Okay, this is the first time you start to experience oxytocin amongst your own family. Then as you grow, you start to experience oxytocin when you're in other groups. It could be your friends at school. It could be as you grow. It could be work colleagues. It could be, unfortunately, gangs are rife with are people flooded with oxytocin. They feel they've got a shared purpose amongst each other, okay? So oxytocin is the one around groups, the feeling of belonging, okay? Whether you are fully geeked out or whether or not you're into your hip-hop, heavy metal, whatever quirk that you have, whatever peculiarity that you have, whatever preference that you have, you know there's a group somewhere out there that you can feel like you belong. That sense of belonging releases oxytocin. Okay, so what can we do to boost our oxytocin levels? You could hug yourself. Try it at home. Try it now. Don't break your mobile phone or anything like that. But just seriously, put down the phone. Just try giving yourself a hug. Praise yourself. Treat yourself. No one should be able to treat you better than you can treat yourself. Go out and spend on yourself. This can release oxytocin as well, but it might break your back balance. You can also meditate, pray, and think about helping other people, because we as a human species were never designed to live in isolation. So oxytocin is our connection to a network that started off with our families, making sure we feel connected. If you haven't done that in a little while, reach out to a family member that you haven't spoke to in a while and just say hi, see how you feel. Another thing you can do is keep a pet. I particularly like dogs, and when I hug my dog Shaka, it is the best feeling you can have. Literally, that joy you feel and his anticipation when he knows that you're coming through that door, because as far as the dog's concerned, you're part of the pack and he's part of the pack. And obviously he's my dog, so he's part of the family too. So that gives me that big sense of oxytocin, that chemical release from my body, making me feel good and loved because I'm connected with my family. So if you want to boost my serotonin levels, send me some oxytocin love. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and share my videos so that my endorphins can start firing up. And maybe, just maybe, I have enough dopamine to motivate me, to inspire me to make another video for you guys out there. Don't forget, all of this means nothing if it's not applied and shared. Each one, teach one. This has been Douglas Hamidiche for NoBodyMotivation.com. I'm out.